Hello everybody, welcome to Matt's Cook House, where I share easy to cook recipes. This week I'll be sharing the recipe for the nut-free version of the ever popular Hyderabadi chicken halim. To begin, in a bowl mix 1/2 cup broken wheat dalia, 1 teaspoon chana dal Bengal gram, 1 teaspoon dhuli masoor dal red lentil, 1 teaspoon dhuli moong dal split green gram, 1 teaspoon dhuli urad dal split black gram, 1 teaspoon tuar dal pigeon peas, and 1 teaspoon rice. Wash them well and soak them for at least an hour. In the meantime, deep fry 1 large sliced onion until golden. Remove to an absorbent paper and keep aside. Add 1/4 cup ghee, clarified butter to the same oil. Add 1 black cardamom, 5 green cardamoms, 10 peppercorns, 5 cloves, 2 cinnamon sticks, and a teaspoon of cumin seeds, jeera. Allow them to crackle. Add a large sliced onion and saute until it colorizes. Next, add 2 tablespoons ginger garlic paste and saute for a minute or two. Now add 250 grams boneless chicken pieces on high heat and saute for a few minutes. You can also use chicken on bone, but have to remove the bones later. Reduce the heat, add the dry masalas, 1 teaspoon salt or to taste, 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder haldi, 1 teaspoon Kashmiri red chili powder, and a teaspoon garam masala powder. Mix well and saute. Add 1/2 cup curd and mix well. Saute for a few minutes. Add a bit of water and pressure cook it on high heat for 4 whistles. Remove the lid and cook until the liquid dries up a bit and the oil starts appearing on the sides. Remove 2 to 3 tablespoons of this oil, rogan, for garnish. Drain the broken wheat and lentils and add it to the chicken. Mix well. Add 1/4 cup chopped coriander leaves, 1/4 cup chopped mint leaves, and 2 whole green chilies. Mix. Add about 3 cups of water. Mix well. Pressure cook on high heat for 1 whistle. Reduce the heat and let it pressure cook for 20 minutes or until the grains are cooked. Remove the lid. Continue to pound and cook on medium heat with a masher until it is nice and smooth, almost gooey. Add milk or water if it is too thick. Finish with 1/2 teaspoon cardamom powder, 1/2 teaspoon black pepper powder, 1/2 teaspoon garam masala powder, 1/4 cup chopped coriander leaves, 1/4 cup chopped mint leaves, 2 tablespoons ghee, and fried onions from earlier. Make sure to save some of the onions for garnish. Continue to cook for another 8 to 10 minutes. Check the salt and add more if required. You can add chopped green chilies if you want to make it spicier. Turn off the heat. Add 3 tablespoons lemon juice and mix well. The Hyderabadi chicken haleem is ready to serve. Garnish with the rogan oil saved from earlier, mint leaves, coriander leaves, lemon juice and veggies, and fried onions. Serve hot. For more such recipes, follow me at Mads Cookhouse and be sure to like, share and subscribe.